Hi everyone, I'm Lisa, and in this video I want to show you the campus of the ETH, Swiss Federal Institute of Technology in Zurich. It is located within a 20 minutes drive from the Zurich Center on the hill Hengeberg. So here we are, on the campus of ETH Hengeberg. It's lunchtime now, so there are a lot of students outside. The weather is really nice, so you can enjoy the meal right here. The location of the Science City ETH Hengeberg is just perfect. In the neighborhood, there are farms where you can buy biomilk, a beautiful forest for walks and jogging, and unforgettable view of the Zurich city opens from here in sunny weather. Not only the various science departments are located around here, but also student accommodation buildings and childcare facilities are here as well, near the university. By the way, these are completely new buildings. They were not here when I was a student and just arrived to Switzerland. On the campus, you will also find a garden with medicinal plants, an electric shuttle bus, a huge underground parking, sports center, and much more. Here it is a bus stop, the so-called ETH Link. ETH Link is a free bus shuttle for the ETH students and employees running since 2009 between the Hengeberg campus and the main ETH campus in the city center. Last year, the fully electric 80-meter-long buses were introduced that can travel around 130 kilometers in one go. So in the meantime, we've come to the sports center of the ETH. Here I also spend a lot of time in addition to the office work and laboratory activities during my study. You know, it is very important to be able to do some sport when you have a high mental load. Luckily, the sports center on the campus offers a wide range of sporting activities. There is a gym, rooms for martial arts, playgrounds for beach volleyball and tennis, bouldering and much more. For those who are fond of bouldering, there is a such wonderful area with a fairly soft coating for safety reasons, so you can come and climb here. As I mentioned in the beginning of this video, right behind the campus there is a large park or even forest, and this is exactly where I like to run, and I even participated in the annual running competition together with my colleagues, where I had to run about 4 kilometers. In 1854, after a long debate, the ETH Zurich was founded by the Swiss Confederation. And in October 1855, the first lecture was given. Initially, there were six faculties: the Faculty of Architecture, Civil Engineering, Mechanical Engineering, Chemistry, Forestry, and another faculty combining such areas as Mathematics, Natural Sciences, Literature, as well as Social and Political Sciences. After the reorganization in 1924, there were already 12 departments, and now there are 16 of them. Currently, 5 areas of study exist. The first one is Architecture and Civil Engineering, with approximately 4,000 students enrolled. In this brown building, I also had a lot of lectures about construction and building materials topics. And I did my PhD in this building, or to be precise, in the building behind it, but these two are connected together. The second is engineering studies, where I studied. By the way, on my channel I have also a video about my experience of studying at ETH, so don't forget to check it if you are interested. All my lectures I had mainly in this building that consists of 5 parts. or five fingers, as they are called, which are connected by one long corridor. And in the last finger is the material science department where I spent almost 2 years. So the third direction of study is natural sciences and mathematics. The fourth is system-oriented natural sciences that deal with the fundamentals of human life and health on an interdisciplinary basis. And last but not least, the fifth area of study is management and social sciences. As for lunch, students have various possibilities. For instance, in this building there is a huge canteen where, as a student, I really like to go to. Then there is another one in the building nearby. There you can find a cafeteria and a dining hall, also a very nice place. One more option for lunch is in this interesting building. It is a canteen with Asian food that I also liked very much. And the architecture of this building is really interesting, isn't it? No wonder that ETH is considered as one of the best universities for studying architecture. By the way, speaking about the architects, here they are. They have these special rooms where they can work on their projects or master thesis. On the campus next to the bus stop, there is an ETH store where you can buy some souvenirs or stationeries if you need something. For example, you can buy different kind of papers. Architects get it from here for their projects, for example. Also, you can even buy a lab gown. It costs 50 Swiss francs. In 2000, the student number were around 11,000. Today, there are over 21,000. For their study, about 500 professors are responsible, and in addition, professors are supported by about 260 senior scientists. ETH attracts talent from all over the world. About 35% of all students, mainly at the master's and doctoral levels, are foreigners. Such a funny story happened to me when I was the first time in this elevator at ETH. So you can see here letters instead of numbers. And that's why I was almost lost many years ago, because I didn't know how to get out of this building, since I couldn't really understand which floor I needed. In Russia I was used to numbers, and when I came here, here the levels are by letters. In this wonderful building I was also awarded with a PhD certificate confirming that I am a doctor of science. By the way, I should also have somewhere a picture taken by my husband exactly on this square after the graduation ceremony. If I find it, I will also attach it. The first construction phase of the Hengelberg campus started in 1961. Since that, in total there were 4 stages of construction. Since 2015, with the support of the Canton of Zurich and together with external experts, ETH has been working to update the development plans of the Hengelberg campus. The development works are based on the master plan known as the Campus Hengelberg 2040. This plan details how the campus will be expanded in the coming decades. ETH is developing the campus because it expects an increase in the number of students and researchers. University creates the space that is necessary for new trends and infrastructures in research and supports innovative teaching methods. So thank you for watching this video till the very end. I hope it was interesting for you. If so, please don't forget to make the thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you don't want to miss new episodes. See you again very soon. Bye.